Detailed studies of our options to keep the planet livable tell us that the climate technologies the world is currently focused on, renewables and electrification, won't be enough. We will need to actively clean up the atmosphere, and that's a huge challenge, one that Livermore is poised to take on. We found three areas where Livermore's strengths can best address this problem: recycling CO2 into carbon products such as ethylene, encouraging the uptake of carbon dioxide by soils, and developing system approaches to this massive problem. Major corporations like the French oil company Total and Shell are focused on how to make today's carbon products but without using petroleum. We are using additive manufacturing to take university-designed catalysts and build them into advanced reactors that can achieve the flux and energy density up to 1 amp per square centimeter required to help companies like Shell replace plants such as this one with factories that will use renewable electricity and carbon dioxide to make the same products. We're the middlemen between pure academic catalysis research and industrial scale application. There are many academic programs in this area, so we have a ripe field of collaborators to bring us great catalytic materials to build into our reactors. Next, we're also looking at the huge target represented by the loss of soil carbon from agricultural practices, worldwide equivalent to almost 500 billion tons of carbon dioxide. We're focused on understanding how native, deeply rooted species like prairie grasses move carbon up to 4 meters deep into soils, which is how the great soils of the American plains were formed. There's no other target that we know of that's this big for negative emissions, but it's also probably the hardest scientifically. The issue is not whether we can come up with better practices, but whether they'll be fast enough to matter. Finally, on the system side, we're focused on implementation issues and removing the barriers to large-scale progress. We need to accumulate and store massive amounts of CO2 underground. About half of the 10 to 20 billion tons I mentioned will have to go 3,000 feet deep into rocks like oil reservoirs. This will use the same technology and expertise as today's oil industry. The U.S. has already put 14 million tons permanently underground in demonstration programs run by the Office of Fossil Energy. Here at Livermore, we've been central to this work since its inception 20 years ago. We know this will work. We think negative emissions are feasible, and the sponsor community is interested in making this into reality. But it's going to be a really heavy lift. We're just at the beginning now, rather like renewable energy in the 1970s. Deploying negative emissions at scale will be one of the great challenges of this century, and we're proud to be leaders in this work.